is up, everybody? My name is Ian C. Jordan. I want to thank everyone for tuning in. We had an interesting week as far as in the news and in the media, and I'm going to get right to it. Tonight we're going to go over how we believe that China created COVID-19 to acquire America. And I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to tell you why I think that way. We're going to also go over Wisconsin Governor Tony Evers. Just basically trying to get a 150-day extension because he's throwing a temper tantrum because he was overstepping his gubernatorial authorities, and now he's going to go to the Department of Health and Services and try to get a 150-day stay-home extension. And I did a video yesterday on that. It's doing pretty well. It's got a few hundred views. You can go check that out. It's called fake COVID and Tony Evers' 150-day extension, I believe. And the last thing we're going to go over today is America will go into an economic free fall if Joe Biden gets a sniff of the White House. So I want to start this off by saying, and everybody knows that I've been critical of the President of the United States. I have been frustrated at some of the things that have gone on. But we can't blame him for everything. That's a dangerous precedent. I watch all the news outlets, MSNBC. I was just watching it before I put this on, before we were doing our show here tonight. And you have people saying that President Obama and Vice President Joe Biden had some kind of pandemic playbook. And the news commentators are speaking as if they've seen it, but none of them seen it. They haven't offered us any tangible evidence that that's even true. So you just can't blame him for everything. Right now, people are saying that he made America poorer, sicker, weaker, and divided. Now, what the media outlets are trying to do now, from what I'm seeing, and again, I'm not the biggest President Trump supporter. I used to be. It's certain things that he did that I don't like. But now they're framing this as if he's the sole reason we have the coronavirus. Hence his now famous "Don't ask me, ask China" line. So I know he exercises in the realm of you can inject people with disinfectants mindset to so many of you. But strangely enough, I knew what he was trying to convey. So a lot of that, people saying that he was supposed to say he wanted you to drink bleach and all that. That's not fair. Even though he's irritating with far as how he handles things, how he handles people, him having a short fuse and seeming like he's emotionally unstable and he's unhinged. I get that. It bothers me too. And I hate to be that guy, but I'm saying it. These over authoritative governors, they need to be removed. They're going to bankrupt their freaking states. They're using this virus as an excuse to rewrite the Constitution, and I'm not going for it, and neither should you. China, in my opinion, created the COVID weapon to weaken our dollar for economic acquisition of America. That will result in almost certain calamity. On another note, if Biden wins America, I said this before, we will go into an economic free fall. We will be like Los Angeles. Businesses will go under with his size mentality. And I said this before, I have no real issues with Democrats. I have no real issues with the left. I have friends from all sides. But it seems like right now with these people, anytime they speak and it requires any type of thought, calamity is inevitable. You cannot, with the Constitution, Tony Evers and the other governors' overreach is treasonous. What do people not understand? A 150-day home order? Stay-at-home order? You've got to be kidding me. And some of you want a Democrat president. LA is what America will look like if Biden wins. And I'm not even going to go into how the crash right now, we have to go ahead and take the interest rates to go below zero. And that's going to weaken our dollar. But right now, you got to do what you got to do. I want to thank everybody for paying attention to what we do. Thank you.